the work before you even, you know, begin. You can also wash it off if you didn't like it, but, you know, it's this idea of working big, nice and chunky, and all that sort of stuff within your painting. You know, you've got that lovely richness in the film. Open it up. You know, use your brush like that. See how it interacts with and creates the like, fantastic wing. And this again is to show not to be mean with your medium, you know, because actually look at that, that's actually medial, isn't it? So what we're actually going to do here is use some old watercolour. When your watercolour dries out, you can actually use that. So, you know, just maybe just put some of that blue stain on the background. And there's plenty of that. So, check out those pieces.
What the hell
did
we book this guy for?
It's just like a real mess, you know. But it's actually that creative freedom. It's quite dry in here, but we might as well start with using this before it dries out. And this is another pro artist brush. It's just like a long handle one. So how we're going to look at the landscape, it's quite good essentially there. I've masked out this area, so what we can actually do, we can actually work into here. And it seems sacrilegious to sort of like blast out all of these beautiful kind of marks you've done. But you have to sacrifice to make a painting work. And if it doesn't work this time, you know, a bit more water on it here, so you can actually, you know, just get a bit more of that sort of like, I'm looking at distance, which actually really helps. So again, this lovely mark, you see these lovely lines in here. This is seen through these trees, so I don't have a problem with this, because I want to show you something else that we're going to do here in a minute. So as you drag these marks like this through here, can you see what's actually happening? It's slightly staining. And because of the acrylic that's been underneath, the acrylic acts as a resist. Everyone heard about the cling film technique? You know, where you actually use that? Well, this is faster. This is like a really quick way of doing it. But I'm just gonna get this a bit more fluid, and you can actually see that rhythm of line. Oh, by the way, anyone who wants to see me painting in the Pennines, go and visit my website and look at, you know, you can see me painting in the Pennines. Thank you. That was an audience participation. or shall we say, audience anticipation. So, yeah, go and look, because you can actually watch, it was a film that was, we did up there on the High Pennines, where the borders sort of, all three borders, you know, mixed together, so it's really great. Now, this is the reason why we work flat easily. So you work these kind of like ideas. So this will create a very beautiful edge, and you can actually just create where it goes melting up there. You can actually just sort of like work that back in, and those kind of like marks will create. So now we've got this yellow here, we can actually just spray this. If we get tighter down here, this is really good, because then you can actually just knock out one or two of those, but they'll be ghosted. Look at this. See? They'll be ghosted. Now before it finishes, you see the water that's on there? That's going to, when we lift that off, that'll be amazing. Because what we're actually going to do here is we actually deliberately spatter it like this, and we can actually add more texture to it. So when you add that like that, then This will actually have lines on it. So what you do is you can crush this up like this, here, and if you place that into position, like that, literally, it will lift out, and you will be interested to see what kind of like marks you will also get and gain. Because you will actually see, look at that, place that in this, over there, close, or here, how's that? Because it's shining light. If I place that there, that's better for me. Now over here, what I've got is a whole combination of these lovely, kind of like, this is all gouache, it's nothing but, I see inside, it stops me being tight as well and fiddly. So thanks for that, it's no problem. So over here, what we can actually do, all I'm doing is looking for shapes. At this stage where all these houses are, which are coming, you know, much closer. There's a bit more brown I need in there. So let's get, see, that's too green. So we want a bit more brown in there. There's probably one in there. But this is a good way of doing it. So what you do is you roll it like this though. You can actually roll these and you can actually then, where it's slightly broken, you can actually, these can form, you know, use your fingernail as well, inside there. And that's why I like to get a screwdriver in and, create, I do, look the kind of like long lines. But down here you can actually move the medium, you can actually, create a hedgerow and bottom end by using that. And then these deeper trees inside here. And then, we can actually start to go back. We'll prop it back up very, very soon. And then, but one thing, just let you know about these. This time, and here. Well, that should be okay. And then we'll just use this gold again. So hopefully, okay, right now, let's just lift that one up carefully. So you get one line there and one line there. So that's really, it looks like you've collaged it, which is absolutely great. I love that sort of. There it is, before you have a look. So what we can start to do is we can just with a bit of silver like this, we can